Let's make believe that Ed and Emily are looking at God's restoration of the earth. This is the first day of God making the earth new again. In Genesis 1:3, then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. The voice of God the Father said, "Let there be light." That's a command. Ed said, "My Bible teacher told me when you're reading the Bible, be on the lookout for God's commands. Underline them. It'll tell you how life really is." So God the Father spoke, and God the Holy Spirit made the light to shine again. In Genesis 1:4, God saw that the light was good. It was exactly what he wanted. So God spoke and the light was restored. Emily said it was instant, like pressing a light switch. Next, God separates light from darkness. In Genesis 1:4, and God separated the light from the darkness. Emily said, "I was taught that all through the Bible, darkness belongs to Satan. Darkness means sin, spiritual death, and the kingdom of Satan." Fact: Satan cannot produce light or life. Only God can do that. And in the Bible, light is used to describe God. In 1 John 1:5, God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. In John 8:12, Jesus says, "I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." Jesus Christ is the light of the world. The unbelievers are in darkness, and God does not want us to be in darkness. In Colossians 1:13, "For he rescued us from the domain of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of his beloved Son." Here's a question. Where did words come from? God started attaching names to things he created. Look in Genesis 1:4. God called the light day and the darkness night. Emily said, "I wondered where words came from. They come from God himself." Vocabulary. One of the most important things to learn is the meaning of words for thinking and for speaking. Ed said, "I need to learn more words. You beat me at words with friends all the time." Here's a fact. The earth began to rotate on that very first day. At the end of verse 4, it became dusk, and then it became morning. That's the first 24-hour day. Notice, the light was not the sun. The light was concentrated above the earth. The sun and the moon and the stars were not put in place until the fourth day. So, the first day shows us that God always does what he plans. He always keeps his word. That we can count on.